Hi everyone and welcome to my new painting video. This time I decided to work in oil paints and I will tell you what I did and why I did in this tutorial. Actually this one is again Patrick, which I've already done in a charcoal portrait, and in the same time it is the currently last photo that I'm working with T-Chart models, and I'm pretty sure I will contact him in the future again for some additional artworks because he does awesome photos, so it's really great to work from. At the time I'm doing this video, Patrick already has both artworks in his home, so I sent them over to him and I hope he is happy about them. If you like, head over to his Instagram profile and have a look. He will post a picture with himself and the drawing and painting very soon. For this painting, I had quite an idea which I wanted to try to achieve here. And this was an idea I had for quite a time in my mind, and this was more or less fitness dude, a direct harsh light onto him, and he's standing in a somewhat dark and rough cave. So this was the idea as a contrast which I had in mind, and I wanted to see how I can transfer it onto the canvas. And before I began painting, I edited a reference photo to look it in a way like I wanted to look. So I searched for some rocks as a reference and placed him in front of the rocks, darkened some areas of the rocks to make it look a bit more like a cave and have the shadows right and to have the contrast in a way that I wanted it to have. Once I had my reference photo, I went into the planning phase, and I'm not that much of a creative guy when it comes to backgrounds, so I don't consider myself to be that creative in most of my time, I say. So I more or less consider myself to be a photorealistic painter, or at least I want to be one at some point, and at times I really do struggle with backgrounds. It became better in the last month, I'd say, so I have more ideas what I can put in the background and things that look good in the background, but I never was really a fan of a solid background color, so I wanted to not to be distracting from the main subject, but I wanted it to be at least, yeah, there, so that you have at least something behind the subject, so not that the subject is only placed on the paper and that's it. So, and as you have seen in my recent work, I also experimented with some watercolors which I painted behind the models, which I really like. So this is something I will continue in the future as well, because I really like it and it's easy and it's quickly done and you can match the colors to the favorite colors of the model, and I think it's a nice idea. And for this one I wanted to test out myself in creating this cave effect, which I've never done before. And therefore I really also had no idea how to make it. Yeah, and the first thing that I did is I tried to match the values. So I used my regular oil paints and a larger brush to block in the darks and the lights, and wanted to see if I can create this stone effect as I had in a reference photo, which I could not achieve. So as my first attempt was a failure and was not the result that I wanted to achieve, and I also had no clue how I could achieve the look that I wanted to have, I decided to go a bit more, well, abstract, and grabbed my palette knife. And I've never painted with a palette knife before. So I just wanted to see where it went and labeled it myself to be an experimental piece again. And for this method I of course had to use way more oil color than I would have used by only painting it, and I also was aware that it will take quite some trying time until I could start working on the rest of the piece. So I started, grabbed my palette knife and applied the color onto my cave painting, as you can see here. And I really did this quite rough and only followed in a way the shapes that I wanted to achieve in the end. Do not have a solid stone wall background, but more or less having some, yeah, some smaller areas and rocks and stones being inside the cave where he is actually leaning against. This went pretty well and it was very much fun working in this kind of technique, because again I never did this before, and it was fun to see, and it was a way more looser style in painting than I normally do. And it also looked better and more cave-like than my initial attempt, and so I was pretty happy with it. And I really liked the rough contrast for the background compared to the becoming smooth rendered model in the foreground. So I really was looking forward to see the contrast and how it really is going to turn out in the end. To help me with the drying time at least a bit, I added some liquid to my oil colors, not very much to make it too thin, but at least some of it to shorten the drying time a bit. And lucky me, it was a sunny day and I was able to put it outside in the sun to make it dry even faster. And this really helped me, I think. So it was at least try to detach in the next day and I could start painting Patrick. But before I start painting him, I decided to change the background color a bit and I mixed some burnt umber and much liquid to make a really thin glaze of my burnt umber color and glazed over the background to give it a more, brownish and more versatile look, to not only have this white black mixed color or grayscale color for the cave, at least to have some more organic colors into it. So I glazed my burnt umber mix over it to give it a tint and to make it even look more dramatic in my eyes. And what it also does, as these very dark oil colors dry a bit matte, applying liquid over it will bring back the color to life, so it makes itself easier to see how it will finally look in the end when you have varnished it. And another good thing, if you have a glaze with so much liquid into it, it only takes about 15 minutes back in the sun outside to have it dried completely, and I was able to work with the skin tones. In the time when it was drying, I mixed my skin colors and I went for somewhat close of the skin color that I have in the reference photo. And if you struggle with mixing skin colors, I have a separate video showing you how to mix skin colors, so head over and have a look at it. And as you have noticed here in this painting, I'm working on an MDF board and this is a very smooth surface. So what I normally do, in the first layer of painting, I normally add just some color to the board in this case, to block in my lights and my darks and the midtones. So I used my darkest color to block in the shadows, used my lightest color to block in the highlights and used some of my midtones to create a bit of the shading. This very first stage normally does not take so long. I think it was done in half an hour or an hour or so. So I did not really count the time, but it went really quickly and you can see some progress on your canvas or MDF board in this case. So once this was dried, I added the next layer of paint and second, third, fourth, whatever, how many layers you will need in the end, I go into more detailing the artwork. So I refine the shadows, I add more highlights and general shading, and I correct colors on the way. And this I normally do by more or less dry brushing over it. So I don't really use much of a paint. So I don't use liquid to thin down my paints, and I more or less dry brush over the areas that are already painted. And this will give you the possibility to change the value or the color or to tint the color. And this makes it, in my opinion, easier than adding large amount of paint over it, which in a way makes blending a bit easier, but it always increases the drying time again. And so if you apply thicker layers of paint over and over and over again, you will have to wait again until everything is dried to put the next layer over it. And once you have too much color onto your painting, it makes it harder in a way to create fine details, at least what I think. So I decided that this method works quite good for me, and so I went for it here as well. And this part, of course, takes the longest in my painting. But I could already see that I will be quite satisfied with the end result because I really liked how it looked already, but I really did not like the hands of it. So what I really did not like was his left hand. In the reference photo, it really had a weird angle, and so I wanted it in the first place to be positioned onto a stone that he actually more or less leans against the stone. But the angle was really, really weird to paint, and could not figure out how to paint it to make it look as I wanted it to look, because if I only copied the hand from the reference photo, it looked strange. And as it always is the case in portraits, if something is weird and strange, the focus of the viewer already goes directly there, and so I just wanted to avoid this, and I blocked a stone right over his hand. So problem was solved, the hand was gone, I had a stone placed there which did not look weird in the end and it matched into the piece and I was way more satisfied with it. And the good thing, the overall feeling that he was leaning against the cave wall still was there, but now he was just leaning against a stone and grabbing it from both sides. So everything was fine for me. And when this first problem was solved, I again struggled with his second hand. And if you know me, you already know that painting or drawing hands is not one of my favorites. And I don't know why, in this special portrait I really struggled painting them. Perhaps it was because of the reference photo, because it was not clear, because the hands were quite in the shadow on the reference and it did not really look as I wanted it to look. And so I decided to make some more of the cave stuff over it. And to give the thing a bit more of a variety, so I decided to use some dark green tones to create some kind of leaves or grass or whatever you see into it, because it's an abstract. So I painted over the second hand a bit to make it look like he's grabbing into grass or something. And I also painted over a bit of his stomach and his underwear to make it fit a bit more into the piece and not ending up at the edge of the piece. So I really wanted to be him the focal point of the artwork and not being distracted when parts of him flowing out of the artwork. Does this make sense? So I really wanted to have in the focal point, and this again helped me in the first place hiding the second hand, which I was not satisfied as well, so I only left a smaller part of his fingers visible and also added some of these grass abstract whatsoever over his body to make it fit into the painting. And I really like the effect. Of course, this was quite some amount of paint, so I had to let it dry again. But in this case, I added some amount of liquid into it, so it should be quite quick. And once this was dried, I just cared for the last details. So glazed over some areas and corrected some shadings and some highlights. I added more details into the hair, and I added finally my logo into his name badge, which he was wearing around his neck. Then it was time for complete drying it, and it took, I think, a week or so. And after everything was dried, I was looking forward to varnish it, because my varnishing days are one of my favorites, because you see all these colors come back alive again. And I filmed it for you here as well, so that you can see what the varnish actually does. And as you can see here, the darker colors are a bit matte. And if you apply the varnish over it, and I use the Gemva from Gamblin to varnish it, and this can be applied once everything is dry to the touch. And as you can see here, once I apply the varnish and go over the areas, everything comes back to life. So the darks get dark again and colors get more vibrant, and this is something I really like. And as this was a quite rough textured one in the end, I think I used 3 coats of varnish to make it look shiny and even, and everything was pretty, and yeah. So I would be happy if you give me a comment if you like this overall piece. So if you like the background, if you like the composition of it, if you like the lighting, because this was something again that I've never done before, and I really liked the result on my own and received quite good feedback on Instagram. If you watch this, I would be happy about getting some feedback from you as well if you like it. And if you have any suggestions what I probably could change or what I could do better in the next painting or whatever you want to tell me, just leave me a comment. I hope you had fun watching it. I of course had fun creating it. It was really an experience for me. And if you have not already, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to not miss anything. If you have questions, please leave me in the comment section as usual, and I hope to see you in my next videos. Have a great day. Bye bye.